TIP in this motherfucker with me, nigga. To the max with it. Rex.
I count 6 shots.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to be doing a little arts and craft video on making a wall decor. So basically what I had envisioned was a 3D sunflower wall clock. So I basically purchased this do-it-yourself wall clock from SHEIN. This is what it's supposed to look like. That little picture at the top. So basically this is going to be for the next video, which is going to be redecorating the house and making it more homey, I guess. We're just going to add some decor and we're just going to spice it up a bit in here. And this is one of the things I wanted to do. I wanted to do a few projects to incorporate into our makeover or whatever. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please remember to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Hey guys, so first off, we're going to cut 12 pieces of this styrofoam sheet. So that way we can use this for the Roman numerals. And we used a hot wire cutter to cut this, but I don't think it was worth it. You'll see why soon. And then I just decided to measure it out to make it even. And just use a ruler for everything, just to make everything precise and more neat. And we lined up the ruler with the actual block, and just to make everything straight and neat. But the hot wire decided to pop on us and it was broke, so it didn't come with the replacement. So that's why I said I don't think it's worth it to buy it. The hot knife worked. We were heating up a knife just to cut it so we wouldn't hear the noise. Then I decided to paint it brown, just to give it like a wooden look, a rustic vintage look. And I also bought this fuzzy yarn from Hobby Lobby as well. And I just dyed the yarn. You can dye this yarn however you feel like it. I recommend buying like the spray tint for the lace and just spraying it, because this was not worth it. And it took a long time to dry. I let it dry on the balcony overnight. And then you just wring it out and let it dry. All right, guys. So day 2. We're going to go ahead and map out the full clock and how, just, I wanted to do this just to see how everything was going to sit and exactly how long I wanted my petals. But I'm going to later find out that this part was really unnecessary. So I decided on 1 foot for the longer petals and 11 inches for the shorter petals. Like I said, that part was unnecessary. You can really just do it however big you want it, but I just wanted everything to come out neat. So I decided to measure everything. So I bought this cloth from Hobby Lobby as well. I just bought 2 yards of it. I didn't even use both yards, but I bought more than enough. And then we're going to go ahead and focus on the middle part of the sunflower, which was the seeds and then the little fuzzies that I decided to make with the yarn. And I used beads as the seeds. I thought that would be really cute. So I just had this picture and vision in my head as to how it's going to come out. And it came out exactly how I thought it would. So the brown beads and the gold beads together just to add some pizzazz or whatever. So I just used the craft glue that I bought from Hobby Lobby as well. The craft glue dried clear as day, y'all. Like, do not fret. Don't fret. Like, it's going to dry clear. And I just put it over a cookie sheet. And that just gave me room so I won't get the beads everywhere. They still were everywhere, y'all, but that just gave me some room. And then I wrapped the fuzzies around and used the craft glue, y'all. The craft glue was my best friend for this project. Like, I love hot glue guns, but the craft glue, that was it. That was the one. And I just felt like that just made everything secure too. And here, there go my chopstick in the middle, if y'all couldn't see. And the chopstick helped, so use the chopsticks so you won't touch everything. And then we decided to go in and add the gold stickers that came with the SHEIN. They're like gold plates or whatever. It came with the SHEIN do-it-yourself clock. So I wanted to add those on there just to give y'all the aesthetic and see what it's about to look like. And then we went in and added our petals to it. And I used a hot glue gun with this because I didn't want to wait for the craft glue to dry. So the hot glue gun did wonders for this part. So I love the hot glue for this part. And I also realized later on that I should have started off with the short petals. So please, if you're going to try this, do the short petals first and then go in with the long petals behind it. But you can always go in there and fill the spaces in that you want to fill in, which you'll see that I do here in a few minutes. I'm going to go ahead and add the petals in there. And then I just fixed everything up around the sides as the fuzzies would be. So now I'm just going in and sprucing everything up now. I just wanted to make sure everything was a bit neater than what it turned out to be because I was flipping the sunflower over and under, I guess. I'm weak. This is terrible. All right, y'all. So the hot glue gun was definitely more useful for the flower. Just gonna go in and spruce it up a bit. All right, moving on to day three, y'all. We added those finishing touches. So we're going to go ahead and go in with some yellow, like a darker mustard color paint, and paint the inner petals for the flower. I just wanted to go in and add this paint because I wanted to make it look more realistic than what it was already looking like. And I feel like this is a really good touch to the project, y'all. Like, I really love this part. This is my favorite part. I already like painting a lot, so I want to do some more projects with painting in it. But yeah, this is my favorite part. And I just decided to do some like brush strokes to make it look more realistic, feather it off. And that was that on that. Let's get into these details, y'all. Look at those beads. Yes. Look how clear the glue dried. Like, I loved it. Like, it was everything. I feel like I could have been a little bit neater on the fuzzies, but I feel like the messiness made the vintage look too, so I really like that part. So day four, y'all, we're about to hang this thing up. So the SHEIN, the wall clock came with like plastic covering over the plates that I added on the top, so that was pretty cool because it kind of like mirrored, you can see the difference here, and it was like a mirror like view. So then I added double-sided tape. This is like sticky 3M tape. And it was like the thicker tape too. It was like chunky. So it's double-sided tape. And I decided to cut a whole bunch of little pieces and add it on the petals. So that way, because gravity is fighting against it, so that way the petals stick up. And they didn't go anywhere, y'all. Like, I'll give y'all an update if they come down ever. Like, if they ever fall down. But I feel like they're going to stay there. So we were taking our time with this part. Like, I feel like this took me probably about 30 minutes to an hour to hang it up, but I feel like it was worth it. And I had to go in and fix some things. I don't know if y'all can see that empty spot, but it was like a spot right here where I had to go in and move the petal around just to make it look more even. And I probably could have added another petal now that I'm looking at it again, but it's fine. And it also turned out to be way different on the wall than it was on the floor. So I ended up doing it a lot wider than normal. So that's another reason why I said you didn't really have to map out the petals. You can just make it as big as you want it. So this, the little paper thing that came with the wall clock from SHEIN, it was very, very, very helpful. Don't try to do it on your own. Like, this part was so helpful. All you have to do is tape it down so it doesn't move around on you. Like, the actual numbers will move with the stem, so you have to tape that down so that it doesn't move around on you. So that way you can make sure everything's perfect and you won't have to go back in and redo it like I had to. But that part was very helpful. Like, I really loved the thing that came with the clock, so that was good or whatever. And you want to go ahead and add the top, the bottom, and the sides first because I want to fill in. I don't want to start like from left to right or right to left or whatever. you want to go ahead and do the points, the 4 points, and then fill it in. And I feel like that was easier too. It helped me measure out everything, make sure I was doing everything evenly. I mean, it just made sense to me at the time. But yeah, that 3M tape, y'all, like the double-sided tape, was very, very, very helpful. Like, I loved it. And it stuck to everything, because at first I was adding the craft glue to the styrofoam and then putting the sticky tape on there, the double-sided tape. But I feel like you could have just used the double-sided tape and that's it, no glue. And y'all, this is the finishing touches. Look at that. Okay. And I later fixed that. All right, guys, that's it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I really had fun doing this little project. Everything was authentic. I made everything up, y'all. So if anybody tries this, I really want to see pictures. I want to see different versions. But if you like this video, please like, comment, and subscribe to my channel if you're not already. Bye, and thanks.
It ain't about the money. Ain't no use to you ringing my line. Stop wasting my time. It ain't about the money.